Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Game It Out. I'm Anthony, watching Josh play The Quiet Man.
Sorry, I'm watching Josh drop the thunder! The Quiet Man!
Let's just go over here, get this guy. I think he's trying to do a little something.
Josh plays as Dane, our deaf protagonist, who is not only fucking gorgeous, but just one hell of a...
Did you see that?
Shifty shifter root. Wait, that guy just warped right through. Is that a turret? Is that a T-1000? Dane can beat up T-1000s.
Not for long. He's like, stop it.
He's like, hey. This is Armani, dickhead.
This guy kicks people's asses the way I feel like we fantasize about effortlessly kicking people's asses.
I gotta say this, though. Small but significant complaint.
I'm ready.
The blood spurts, they always... if they go up in Dane's mouth.
Oh, there's a guy still alive.
Kick his ass!
Can I, like, push him into the tracks? You know?
Oh, do it. Like, yeah.
Oh, no. The game. Oh, man.
That'd be great. Murder.
Is he presenting for a second?
Death. Kill.
The Dane way of doing things.
No.
Oh, it's this guy again.
Wait, now he's got a machete?
Well, yeah. Had a machete.
Oh, did you see that?
Do not. Fuck. Into his mouth.
Ew.
Right into his mouth.
See? So,
So these are the flashbacks we get with Dane, who... I can't remember if you mentioned this, but he himself is deaf.
Yes.
Mentioned that. Which is the explanation for...
And that's the thing. This is... these flashbacks were led to believe that Dane lost somebody special to him in his childhood. I think from this same game.
Right. And so, intentionally, we don't get a lot of subtitles in this game, and we are left to interpret things as we see fit, which means you get the Let's Game It Out interpretation of many things.
Right, and I think that's his father.
Like all...
I think that's the implication.
Who TP'd the house. Yeah, I agree with you. I totally agree with you.
And this is sort of explaining maybe how Dane became deaf, because he's holding his ears. I think his father beat him up a little bit. So this is, a cheery episode.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, my God. Is
oh,
that
Jesus.
A-
don't do it. Don't
wait,
don't
I don't
do
know
it.
What he's doing. Is he
I
like,
think I know what he's doing.
No.
Yep.
Oh, does he do it?
I think he did it.
Oh.
I think. And now it's... Geez. But we don't.
I thought he was just like sitting like, oh, should I not? Huh.
No, I think the implication is that he did, but we don't hear it because Dane couldn't hear it.
Because Dane... Right, because Dane was... And then more...
Which I think is an interesting storytelling technique, honestly.
Yeah, totally.
Little tough.
More of the clone fighters showed up, so...
Yeah, I mean, this gang, you know, they have a very specific way of recruiting, which is they just clone themselves.
Yeah.
They cut out the middleman.
This is more henchmen than the Joker has, for Christ's sake.
Oh, should we posture for a while? It's just like,
Yeah, baby.
All right. Should we go all kicks all the time? Is that what I'm hearing?
Fly like a butterfly, sting like a bee, Josh.
All right, hold on.
Ah!
Are you stuck on the landscape? Because that's how Dane gets his kicks in.
God, this is...
Oh, are you still alive?
Don't get blood on my Gucci's.
All right, I'm going to be honest, Anthony. Wait, is this guy trying to get up? You trying to get up, dude?
Go ahead. Do it. Get up, punk.
Nope. I think he
Please.
Put that knife down.
Come on, Bumblebee. Who are you kidding? Shit.
Wait,
uh-oh, right, Josh, your juice is getting higher. Crack-a-lack-a-crack-a-lack-a-crack.
Get him up against this bench. Wail on him. Now, I haven't spent a lot of time in L.A. Oh, God, he just pushed his foot entirely through that guy.
He's like, just in time for my train.
I haven't spent much time in New York, excuse me. But I feel like there would at least be some people to witness this, right?
No, honestly, I've been in, we've both been in New York, but like I've been to subway stations where like there are some of them are small and deserted.
Are you seeing this?
He's just... Our main protagonist just whooping ass.
God. And then smoldering his way to victory.
I know, he's just thinking he could go get something else for free because he's hot now.
Who is this guy?
He's like, hey, I really like your Chinese food, and I just beat up 12 guys who all look similar.
Some people can...
That's a famous actor, right?
That guy?
I think so.
Define famous.
I'll have to look it up. Like, character actor. I think he's a well-known character actor. I'll have to look it up.
I think if you're...
Law and Order, maybe?
A well-known character actor, then no one knows you, right? Because then you've succeeded in really blending in. I feel like Philip Seymour Hoffman did that.
But that's my point, but you're recognizable.
Right.
You're recognizable. I think this guy's recognizable.
Maybe.
Let's see him.
Maybe.
He's not as recognizable as this guy's amazing.
He also looks like he could be the stunt double of Bruce Willis.
Right.
I would buy that.
Maybe this is like a good side gig for him.
And I feel like if he put sunglasses on and went to a convention and pretended to be Bruce Willis, he could probably take some of Bruce Willis's money. I believe that's called fraud, but...
Oh my God.
That sequence is beautiful.
No, I mean, I've seen you in that jacket. Oh. You look great in that jacket.
thanks, man.
You don't even, I mean, you don't have shoulder pads, but, you know, I get it, sign of the times.
I hope he's like, I must have it, and just, like, walks through the door, doesn't even have to punch it.
I like sparklies. Sparkles.
Fuck.
Sparkles.
My cheek hit decline. Damn it. Yeah, honey, there's just some guy outside. Yeah, I think he likes my jacket.
Yeah, he's there again. I don't think he thinks I think he knows I see him, but he's there.
I think he thinks it's like one-way glass. Oh, okay, oh, they know each other.
Okay.
That's what I do.
I shall now retreat to the dark.
When ladies wave at me, I'm like, nyah!
My hotness is not at 100% yet. Only then shall I approach mine maiden. Goodbye, lover, from afar.
What is going on?
Speaking of shoulder pads, do you remember the 8-minute series, like 8-minute abs, 8-minute arms?
Sure.
Have you ever done those workout videos?
No. That sounds way like a lot of work.
They're great. But one of them, 8-minute arms, at the very beginning, the guy's like, you don't have a big, sexy chest. That's why women wear shoulder pads. And it's like, oh, product of the 90s and
the
80s.
What are you watching? I just want to work out my abs.
I just want to work my arms out for 8 minutes.
Thanks, Beatrix.
All right, Steven Seagal.
Yeah.
You wait outside.
I just took a...
I'm here to pick up my date for prom.
Yeah. I just lost about 5 pounds on the can. That shit last night was amazing.
So wait, are we led to believe that Dane sort of just lurks in the shadows as a protector?
Probably.
Uh-huh.
Oh, damn.
She kind of hovered over them.
Oh, my God. I can see into your soul. Girl, I know you can. Take these. Smells like...
No, I want them back. I take it back. Ah, Dane. Good to see you here. Here for our triple date.
I assume McDonald's again? Yeah, and this...
No. McDonald's and Arby's.
And this time, order a small drink. It's free refills.
Yeah, that's just good economics.
Yeah. Frugality is hot.
She's just like, uh-huh.
She's like, I just don't want Arby's again. The cheddar makes me, I don't know, squishy.
And again, to be clear, there's intentionally no
girl
subtitles.
Right.
Which makes it sound like we turned them off so it could be a bunch of jackasses, but this is really how it's supposed to be, according to the Steam page.
Yeah. Yeah, this is really how it's supposed to be. Us interpreting this as a conversation about Arby's and McDonald's.
Well, that's not quite what I meant, but I think that is canon now. Like, if you find the wiki for this, which we're going to now write.
Yeah.
God, that guy on the left. Like, you're in good company. You don't have to... Oh. Hey, Dane.
Don't worry, I haven't changed yet, because I don't need to. I don't
Everyone's
sweat.
Just like, oh, Dane, you're here again.
Program executed. Search and destroy completed.
Like, you can't keep coming out with me on all my dates.
Yeah, look, man. We talked about this. you brought me another dead bird, Dane. God.
He's like, not here, dude.
Dude, it's weird. Yeah, I told you that's disgusting.
I think what's really happening is he's like, I found another thing leading me to the gang or something.
Or that, right? I think it's like that gang is, they left that as a thing for him because they know, like, they're monitoring the woman. They know he goes there to look after her.
Right.
And so they're like, we got eyes on you, sucker.
He's like, don't worry, I'll have him killed.
He's like,
I don't know if you know this, but with money, you can do anything.
I got it taken care of. I had every bird in the city killed. There's no way they could leave us more clues.
Go with pink tie over here. He'll get you cleaned up.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm telling you, it's totally manly. If you just wear a pink tie, I mean, what's the big deal? I'm comfortable with it.
Oh, he's doing the thing again.
I have sweaty palms.
Here you go. And the guy's like, come on. Come on. No, Dane, it's not for you. No, Dane. Oh, well. Okay.
I graduated the top of my class at the Zoolander School of Modeling, so Dane first. Get in, less hot people.
This dude's just like, ugh. God, every time.
I'm telling you, that guy, can you just buy him some Kleenexes?
Classic Dane.
God, I still hunched over after that major deuce I had.
So what is with the two dudes hanging out by the stairway? Like, is it part of their job description to look like scowl as hard as they possibly can?
Yeah, man, they're guards, hardcore guards.
Yeah. You know, you look super hardcore if you, like, shove your lower teeth out.
Yeah.
And furrow your brow. No smiling.
All right, let's go.
All right, guys.
No smile. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. You two with me.
Guess we're walking home. Dane claimed the car, guys.
Yeah.
Pack it up.
Listen, he did it again. He's had a bad night. We don't want to push him. So just, he gave me a dead bird. You know what that means. So let him have the car. And let's get an Uber. Bye, guys.
You're Dane, right?
Don't fucking touch me.
She's like, that's cute. Are you? What?
Only.
He just looks at her, Dane, and that's all he'll say.
Wouldn't it be great if he just reached up and like put his finger in her nose, like, shut up now.
I do that to my wife all the time.
I could hear you talking the whole time. And I didn't like anything you had to say, you stupid person.
You have to look at him, lady. Can't just look elsewhere like it's a movie. Look at him intently looking at her. She needs to talk straight back, or else this isn't going to work. Or he's just staring, one of the two.
So, I'm trying to read what she says. So, do you like tacos?
She's not, her mouth isn't moving yet.
She was.
Time to go to second Dane.
Yeah, she's like, Dane, what's sign language for I want to have all your babies?
That's it. That look right there. The Liv Tyler from Lord of the Rings look.
That's not the Liv Tyler. Uh-huh. Is there an even look from that?
It's just Liv Tyler in general. That's it.
She's all That's right. It. She was a cool elf, I guess. He's like,
let's get back to Dane, though.
I'm just not Corey Haim. I'm sorry.
She's like, Dane? Dane.
Hard to get. You're not a model, and Dane is hard to get.
He just opens the door, just walks out.
You see the camera pan down to the red eject button. Boom.
And it looks like that. It's just that symbol.
Yeah. All right, dude, what do you think?
You've won the game.
Do we come back to this? I think we
absolutely. All right. We'll see you guys next time for more of The Quiet Man.